Alrighty, welcome to another bug fix release video. This bug was reported by somebody that was an actual crash bug. It turned out I was misunderstanding one of the parameters in the preset file. It's called the side parameter, and it had to do with if you had a stereo file, whether you're using the left or right channel of that file. And previously, this also because of that, it turns out I also didn't actually support selecting the right channel from a stereo file. So that was just a missing feature that was missing. That's why it's called a missing feature, right? In any case, that bug also caused the module to crash. If you were in this instance and had the same problem, it would crash if you went to the sample or loop screens on the module. Hard crash, just kind of hang it. The audio would play if you tried to play that sample. And the one instance besides the misunderstanding in the app that you could get into this problem is if you had a preset with a stereo file that you had selected the right channel for, and then sometime later you converted that file to a mono file, so the preset was trying to load it and access the right channel. So anyways, fixed that bug in the application. And part of that fix was adding these new buttons here on the right side of the file selector here. So if we were to go ahead and load up a stereo file now, you can see this is loaded up as the left channel. And now when we look over here at the right channel screen, we see that this is the right channel being used here. So that allows you to select those right or left. We can select the right channel here and use both right channels on that if we wanted to, or swap them around, use left, etc. And if you load up a mono sample here, those buttons are not enabled at all because it's a mono sample. One of the other things that I needed to fix around this support was the audio playback. Previously, if you loaded up a stereo sample and had the left and right channel of that stereo sample here, then that would play correctly in the playback. But if you selected a different sample for the right channel here, then that would not play correctly. It would still try to play the stereo version of whatever the left channel was assigned to the master channel. This one's got noise in it, so let's go ahead and change to a different sample here that is stereo as well, and change that. Oops, that's okay, we can do that, right? And now we've got that on the left and right channels there. As you can see, also the waveforms show slightly different now because we're actually showing the correct waveform for this sample here. The other byproduct of the change was fully understanding that you cannot edit the parameters for the right channel on a master stereo pair. It uses the settings from the master channel. I didn't have time in this release, but in a future release, I will display the left channel settings here, the master channel settings, so you can see that they're the same as this one, but just know that the module uses the left channel settings no matter what you change them to, including loop points, etc. The three things that you can edit from a stereo right channel is whether it's what the sample is, whether it's a left or right, if it's a stereo sample you're loading here, and of course turning off the stereo mode into master mode or one of the other modes. I think I said so. The other byproduct of fixing this is, of course, fixing playback, so playback works correctly. One of those fixes was also getting mono samples to play in both speakers. So now if we play this one, you can hear that we got those in both speakers now. And now if we go back and play this bongo, we got it playing there. And we can even, let's go ahead and make obvious that we're playing two different things here. We got one in there and we got the bongo left channel in here now. It is using the left channel's length to play that back. I'm not sure if that's correct now that I just ran that. I'll have to test on the module. But anyways, it's more correct now. So stereo files now play back correctly. You can now select a left or right channel for your stereo files. Mono files play back correctly. I disallow the editing of the right channel settings here, except for mode, sample, and left or right selection if it's stereo. Two other bugs that I fixed while I was here. One was a bug. Another user reported that he couldn't launch the app. And so I switched the application to use what's called static runtime libraries instead of dynamic runtime libraries. And that will make the application a little bigger, but also means that if somebody doesn't have the right runtime libraries installed, the application still runs. And lastly, I noticed if you had length end or use loop length as end set to end, and when you initially loaded the preset, the value here was incorrect. So I fixed that now, and it often would show up as red because of the value not being correct for the end mode. So that's it. I think the audio playback stuff improvements are great. That's going to be really helpful. And also for anybody who was finding this not usable because you couldn't select between the left and the right, sorry I hadn't even thought about that when I was working on it. Hopefully that'll be useful. And I'll be getting that out today.